Hi, I'm Leah Pratt, and I'm one of the Bible teachers here at the high school at Heritage. This is my sixth year of teaching here, and prior to being at Heritage, I actually worked as a mental health professional for 10 years, working with teenagers and their families, and prior to that, had worked in youth ministry at churches and in a camp setting. And you know, it's interesting, in more of my years than not, the past 20 plus, I've been working to teach teenagers the Bible in multiple contexts. But I'm beyond thrilled that God has chosen fit to see me in this role here at Heritage for this time, to come alongside you as parents to help disciple your children. You know, I actually live almost an hour south of Heritage, and when my students find that out, I always get these weird questions like, why in the world do you drive an hour every day? Wait, it's 2 hours every day. And my only real thought back to that is, well, I do that because I love you all, and I do that because I love the Lord, and this is what He's given me to do. And I realized, I think, as I came to Christ at about 13, that as I was growing as a teenager in the Lord, that was just a really trying time for me. And so I think beyond that, you know, post-teenagerville, I really felt this need to help young people be discipled in a way that I really didn't get an opportunity to be. I was active in a church that had discipleship programs per se, but there was nothing really deep about the faith that I was learning. And for a long time, I struggled, and I tell the students this a lot, struggling with doubts about assurance of salvation, you know, praying every time, Lord, if I'm not saved, save me now. And I find some that resonates with a lot of the students here, that they've been raised in a way that you parents are doing so well to understand the faith from such a young age and to know and revere Christ in a great way, but they've yet maybe to make their faith fully their own, right? They've understood the things that they need to know about the gospel. They're starting to piece those things together in life, but maybe there's a void somewhere, not because of lack of something that you're telling them or the church is telling them, but because as teenagers, we all know, we've all been there. Some things we just need to hear from a different angle or hear from a different perspective for us to really start grasping those contexts and putting them into place in our life. And so I do adore that about Heritage, being able to partner with you all as parents to really reach your kids at this poignant part of life, this space and time where questions are flying and they want to dig deep and find answers and ask those hard-hitting things and really probe the areas of fear and doubt in their lives and get those things figured out. And I just really love the opportunity to be able to do that with them here at Heritage. Now, in the high school, the Bible teachers teach semester-long courses in very specified areas within the scriptures. And so my courses really fall in an area I like to call practical theology. I teach some doctrinal classes on the attributes of God, life of Christ, missions, history, and theology. But to zero in on a couple of specific examples, like what your students might see in this classroom, classic example, biblical manhood and womanhood. This is a class for 9th and 10th graders, where they come in and we talk through the divine design that God has given to men and women. We talk about how He has made us equal yet different. We try to tackle how to have a biblical worldview when all the world is pushing at us is sin and the glorification of that sin. And so we talk through living as God intended, things like identity, sexuality, purity, and relationships, and not only honoring what you all as parents have instilled in them, but what the Bible really says for those areas of life. There's an upperclassman course I teach in biblical counseling, in which we seek to understand God as like the wonderful counselor that the scripture says He is. We look at a range of ways with all the problems and sufferings in the world that we treat those problems, right? From secular psychology and therapy models all the way to Christian and biblical counseling techniques. And so hopefully your student, when they emerge from that class, can help their friends, help their younger siblings possibly navigate through some of life's hard things with that biblical worldview, you know, applying that to the hard things of life. A couple of unique things about a Pratt Bible class, I guess. I have a question box. I have it with me actually here. It's the lovely Mario coin box. But kids put questions in this box all the time. Some classes more than others. I would say manhood and womanhood sees this box quite frequently. And they'll drop questions in there that maybe they're afraid to ask. Maybe they don't want their peers to know they don't know something. And so we go through those on kind of a regular basis, depending on the semester, depending on the quarter and what we're talking about. Sometimes I'll even end quizzes or tests with a question that's actually worth points, that they write a prayer request in. They write something that's on their heart, a concern that they really maybe want help with, need prayer for. And so I'll write back to them as I'm grading their test how I'm praying for them about that specific thing, just to try to connect. And honestly, more often than not, it's the out of class time, you know, where we as Heritage staff and faculty try to connect with your child, your student, in a one-on-one setting, maybe a one-on-two, one-on-three with some of those small groups. Friends that just pop in and out the doorway before school, after school, at lunchtime, and those kind of unintentional moments where we still try to intentionally disciple. Honestly, that's what sets Heritage apart. Faculty and staff seeking your students inside and outside of the class to really partner with you, fulfilling our distinctive not only to teach and train, but to mentor, to really truly disciple at a deep level. When people aren't familiar with Heritage and they ask me what it's like here, you know, what is it like to teach Bible like full-time at a school, at a Christian school, I usually say it's kind of like a pre-Bible college atmosphere. It's really my only way to describe it. At one point in my, you know, past educational career, I was at a Bible college, and I remember, you know, the academics being rigorous, and I think we have that. You know, college prep school, kids are taking core classes that are at an elevated level, but we don't want to skimp out on the Bible in that area. We don't want the Word and the Lord to be out of reach for your student, but we do want to intellectually study through the scriptures with them. To borrow a phrase I'm sure we've all heard 1,000 times, we don't want our students to be a mile wide and an inch deep. We want them to be maturing in Christ, no longer being the spiritual infants that we see Paul emphasize in Ephesians 4. And so those who are tossed back and forth by the waves of life, that is not something that we're trying to encourage, but rather the opposite, to be built on the firm foundation. And so, like I said earlier, I'm beyond thrilled to serve you and your students here at Heritage, and I pray that you, similarly, would be beyond thrilled to have your child join us as well.